try to call everybody up. Mr. 18 Mishra, are you on the dice? Before I give this time over to Mr. Biju, what I do ask the chair of the panel is to ensure that all speakers stay within the limited time. We want to make sure we give the audience an opportunity to ask questions, and also kind of so you can have more time to discuss what you've discussed. I know there's very important questions out there, both in Hindi and English, so please think about your questions. Also, the audience, while you sit during the discussion, what I encourage you to do is think of questions and try to limit your questions to questions, not comments, but questions. Write them down for yourself so you know what you want to ask when you come forward. So thank you very much. At that point, now I'm going to hand it over to Mr. Biju Matthew. Thank you.
Hello again. So I have been asked if the panelists would be willing to keep their talks to 5 minutes each so that we can have enough time and you can have enough time to ask questions. So without further ado, I would like to introduce Mr. S.N. Pradhan. He's the ADGCID of Jharkhand Police Initiatives as one of our keynote speakers. Sir, if you would be willing to join, and come on up.
Thank you, the chair. मैं यहाँ देख रहा हूँ कि बहुत पुलिस ऑफिसर्स भी हैं और भी लोग हैं और मैं समझता हूँ कि you'd prefer that I speak both in English and Hindi as much as possible when I try to put my points across. जो सबसे पहली बात है, the first issue is हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं कि इट इज अ राइट्स इशू, ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग अधिकारों से जुड़ा हुआ है. जो सबसे पहली बात हम लोग को समझने की जरूरत है, क्योंकि मैं पुलिस और लॉ एनफोर्समेंट के रिस्पॉन्स के बारे में बात करने आया हूँ, तो जो सबसे पहली बात हम लोगों को समझने की जरूरत है वो ये है कि राइट्स अपने लिए भी होती है, व्यक्ति के अपने लिए, और राइट्स किसी के अगेंस्ट होती है या विजावी किसी के होती है, किसी सिस्टम के. ये बहुत मौलिक कॉन्सेप्ट है जो हम लोगों को समझने की जरूरत है, और इसे समझने की इसलिए जरूरत है कि व्हेन यू से दैट दिस इज अ ह्यूमन राइट्स इश्यू, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट द राइट्स हैव टू बी रिस्पेक्टेड and protected. When that happens in the context of human trafficking, and there was a very nice graphic about a pipeline, I think you said about the pipeline, you must have noticed that right at the beginning of the pipeline is police. It's a travel from injustice to justice. Right at the door of the first port of call for justice is police. So it is, you are standing at the entrance. Sorry, there are यहाँ पर बहुत पुलिस ऑफिसर्स हैं. मैं आपको भी कहना चाहता हूँ कि अगर आप उस क्रिमिनल जस्टिस सिस्टम के दरवाजे पर खड़े हैं और उस दरवाजे पर कोई आता है और आपको ऐसा लगता है कि वो अपना अधिकार आपसे मांग रहा है, क्योंकि वो कह रहा है या कह रही है कि मेरे साथ अन्याय हुआ है और मेरे अधिकार के खिलाफ मेरा शोषण हुआ है, मेरे खिलाफ दरिंदगी हुई है, अपराध हुआ है, ऐसे सिचुएशन में हमारा रिस्पॉन्स क्या होना चाहिए और क्या है, इसके बारे में आज हम लोग विचार कर रहे हैं. मुझे लगता है कि हम लोगों को, सब लोगों को यह मानना चाहिए, मानना पड़ेगा कि बहुत पहले तक, मतलब हाल तक, बहुत हाल तक हम लोगों ने मानव तस्करी, ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग को शुद्ध क्राइम अपराध का दर्जा दिया ही नहीं। आज ये अलग बात है कि पन्ना लाल अपराधी के रूप में जाना जाता है, लेकिन 5 साल पहले उसको अपराधी की संख्या नहीं दी जाती। और ये केवल आम आदमी नहीं करता था, पुलिस ऑफिसर्स भी करते थे, पुलिस थाना भी करता था, और हम लोग वरीय पदाधिकारी भी इसके इंपोर्ट को, इसके इम्प्लीकेशन को नहीं समझते थे। नायक सर ने कहा कि 2004 के सर्वे में एनएचआरसी ने कहा कि 95% पुलिस ऑफिसर्स को इसके बारे में मालूमात नहीं थी। मैं तो ये कह रहा हूं कि 95% ऑफ सोसाइटी को इसके बारे में मालूम है। और मेरा मानना है, आई फर्मली बिलीव इन दिस सेक्टर, द पुलिस विल बी एज अवेयर और अनअवेयर एज द सोसाइटी इज। व्हाई इज इट दैट इन अ प्लेस लाइक केरला it is very difficult to damage or take away the rights of a person because he is educated, he or she will come and claim? And why is it that that lack of awareness is exploited in a different context like in Jharkhand? So to come back to the state response, of specifically to the law enforcement response, there was an issue that was discussed in passing, exploitation. Exploitation is the key word. Exploitation, जो शब्द है, इसको key word के रूप में माना गया है human trafficking context में। हम सभी को समझने की जरूरत है, जो लोग हैं पुलिस ऑफिसर्स और समाज के जो भी लोग हैं, जिस तबके से भी आए हैं, एनजीओ से आए हैं, कहीं से भी आए हैं, exploitation एक static concept नहीं है, पहली बात। और एक्सप्लॉयटेशन का दायरा बहुत ज्यादा है, बहुत ज्यादा है। अब मैं आपसे एक सवाल पूछना चाहता हूं कि कुछ दिन पहले हमारे पास, दैट वी आर द डोर ऑफ जस्टिस, राइट, एंड आवर डोर वाज अ केस विथ विच वी आर स्टिल स्ट्रगलिंग, गुड्डा से 500 से ज्यादा बच्चों को लिया गया और उनको पढ़ाई के नाम पर अनाथालय में लिया गया। पढ़ाई के नाम, निश्चित रूप से उनके माँ बाप उनको, उनकी उन्नति के लिए, उनकी तरक्की के लिए उनको उन्होंने भेजने का डिसीजन दिया, उसमें गलती नहीं। अब ये उस एक्सप्लॉयटेशन के दायरे में आता है कि नहीं आता है, यही समझने की बात थी। मैं अभी भी ये नहीं कहना चाहता हूं कि वो एक्सप्लॉयटेशन था अथवा नहीं, यह तय नहीं है। मैं ये कहना चाहता हूं कि पुलिस ऑफिसर, एनजीओ, जो भी इसमें सोशल एक्टिविस्ट काम कर रहे हैं, उनके जहन में ये बात होनी चाहिए, दे मस्ट इंटरनलाइज दिस, दैट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन हैज टू बी इंक्वायर्ड इनटू, इट विल नॉट बी सेल्फ प्रूवन। आपको एक्सप्लॉयटेशन को इंक्वायर इनटू करके उसको प्रूव करना है। सो इट विल रिक्वायर व्हाट इज कॉल्ड ड्यू डिलिजेंस फ्रॉम योर साइड टू प्रूव व्हाट इज एक्सप्लॉयटेशन। I gave this context of rights and exploitation because हम लोगों ने झारखंड पुलिस की तरफ से इसी दो, इन दो प्लेटफॉर्म से काम की शुरुआत की और इस अवेयरनेस को लोगों में हमने डालने की कोशिश की, इंक्लूडिंग आवर पुलिस ऑफिसर्स जो इनिशिएटिव्स के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं कि एक ये अधिकार है और आप अधिकार आपके खिलाफ है, मतलब इट्स अ गवर्नेंस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी। आम आदमी जो मांगता है अपना अधिकार तो वो गवर्नमेंट से मांगता, किससे मांगेगा, गवर्नमेंट से मांगता, स्टेट से मांगता है और स्टेट के हम पार्ट हैं, सो वी मस्ट बी इन अ पोजीशन टू गिव और प्रोटेक्ट दैट राइट। और दूसरी जो बात है कि वी मस्ट आल्सो फाइंड आउट विद आवर ओन इनिशिएटिव हाउ बेस्ट टू प्रोटेक्ट द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ दैट ट्रैफिक पर्सन। द अदर इश्यू दैट आई वांट टू फ्लैग इज, there is a very important concept in social science which says anything that cannot be measured cannot be improved. Anything that cannot be measured cannot be improved. Jis samasya ka parimap aapke paas nahi hai, uska samadhan aapke paas nahi ho sakta. Isliye aapko samasya ke parimap ko jaana, you should be able to measure the problem and you should able, you'd be able to track the problem in terms of data. The same applies to the solution. You should be able to measure the solution, and you should be able to track the solution as it develops. In that light, we have tried to set up what is called a data portal, a data base in Jharkhand. At least we are talking about the measurability of what is the problem, the dimension of the problem. We have tried to bring out some indices, put it down to figures, and try to measure the problem. I'm not saying that the work is over, the work is at best a work in progress, but we are trying to do that. And the second issue is, on the basis of that, you have to also calibrate the resolution or the solution that you are trying to get. Unless you do that, I think you are always making false starts, and we keep meeting again and again like this, but we are not arriving anywhere. We don't know whether we have progressed from the last conclave to this conclave in terms of these indices. I think this is very critical. This is one initiative that Jharkhand Police has started to take. We have set up what is called an integrated database management system. We are trying to put in more and more data into it. It is just at the initial stage. Other institutional initiatives, RIG, Organized Crime, Sampath will talk about in the afternoon. But what I have tried to tell you, just to sum up, is that first, all of us must understand that if we are talking of convergence, and if we are talking of delivering justice at the end of the pipeline, it is everybody's business. It is everybody's business. Number one, everybody has to pool it. And this is the theme of the workshop today. The second is that we have to be very particular about the legal implications of the remedies that we are giving. How deeply we can, with due diligence, prove the point that there has been exploitation. And finally, what I say is, we must be able to measure both the problem and the solution. On all these three fronts, conceptually, we have started working in Jharkhand Police. And the other aspects of post-problem rehabilitation or prosecution, etc., will be talked about from the institutional perspective by Sampath in the afternoon. Just one last point before I go is that cases like the case of Pannala or any other case of human trafficking that comes to come across, we find that they have big new dimensions added to it. Let me say in the four walls, within these four walls, that the money of Pannala may have been the money of many other allied co-conspirators. Maybe he was managing that money. Maybe that front that he is using for placement agency that he runs is actually a front to launder others' money, also his own money, his own money. So the dimensions keep expanding as you go into it deeper and deeper. Fortunately now, there is a will to go into these issues deeper and deeper. And I believe when we do that, there will be more dimensions that comes up. I'm very happy that Dr. Nair brought out the issue of trafficking by Naxals. And let me leave you with this example. In Latehar, about a year or 1.5 years ago, 10 boys were taken away by Naxals. On the pretext of punishing the villagers for planting trees at a place which was not permitted by them. That was actually a pretext. Un bachcho ko le liya gaya aur unko naksal banane ke liye IIT ki training di jane lagi. Aur usi darmiyan IIT ki training lete hue ek bachcha last mein mara gaya. Mera aapse ye prashn hai ki bahut sare NGO yahan par baat utha rahe hain ya kuch log ye bhi baat utha rahe hain ki hamara protection kyon nahi hota hai. निश्चित रूप से पहली बात अव्वल तो ये है कि जब आप सोशल सर्विस कर रहे हैं तो आप छाती ठोक के सोशल सर्विस करिए, प्रोटेक्शन के नाम पर चिंता मत करिए. आप किसी का प्रोटेक्शन खुद दे रहे हैं, आप अपना प्रोटेक्शन के बारे में सोचेंगे तो दूसरे को क्या प्रोटेक्शन देंगे. ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ कि आपको प्रोटेक्शन नहीं चाहिए, लेकिन दूसरे के हक की लड़ाई लड़ने वाला डरता नहीं. दूसरी बात कि जब इस तरह की कार्रवाई होती है मुझे लगता है कि मीडिया और समाज सबको खड़ा होना चाहिए कि नक्सली भी ट्रैफिकिंग कर रहे हैं। मीडिया कुछ हद तक इस पर जरूर तवज्जो दिया था, लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि बहुत सारे ऐसे सिविल सोसाइटी ग्रुप्स हैं जो चुप रह गए। क्यों चुप रहे, ये मैं आंसर नहीं दे सकता, वही ज़्यादा बखूबी आंसर दे सकते हैं, लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि जब अधिकार की बात हो रही है तो किसी के अधिकार का हनन हो रहा है, चाहे वो बच्चा हो, और अधिकार का हनन करने वाला चाहे कोई भी हो, चाहे नक्सली क्यों ना हो, हम लोगों को एक साथ आवाज़ उठानी चाहिए। धन्यवाद।
Thank you, sir, for sharing and about the state and law enforcement's response to human trafficking, especially focusing on issues of rights versus exploitation and challenging us to think and consider how do we measure the crime and measure the statistics so that we can better prove what's going on. Now, without further ado, I would like to invite Mr. Mandalar Mandal from ATSEC, and he will be sharing with us. He is a foremost scholar, especially in the legal side on human trafficking.
Mr. Chairperson, respected friends on the dais and off the dais, I think law enforcement and state response is very challenging, because state wants to do everything and law either prohibits or expands if you want. My work has been made very easy by earlier speakers in the earlier session, by you and Dr. Nayar. I personally belong to the organization, another organization called Socio-Legal Center, which takes up counseling of the victims in government homes, legal cases on behalf of the victims in different books of law in West Bengal and elsewhere. And we have an MOU with the West Bengal government to look after the cases of such victims in different books of West Bengal, especially those who are in the government books. And also we take up the repatriation. Almost every month we are repatriating victims released from court to Bangladesh after following the letter procedure. Now, like proactive, I mean, so far as the enforcement of legislations are concerned, legislation by itself need to be implemented. There are a lot of difficulties in implementation and also lack in implementation. Why? Why do we try to provide legal justice? There are three things need to be kept in mind. One, after the rescue, we might target whether it is public, whether it is NGOs, whether it is police, after rescue investigation starts. Unless the investigation is properly done, the case is bound to fail. So we need dedicated, committed, and informed police officials to take up the investigation, and trained officials, of course. Now, Mallimat Committee did suggest a separate investigation unit within the police. That didn't work. Our police takes up investigation officers. Then next day, possibly, he goes for the law and order work. Very next day, he will again go to for VIP duties. He will find a gap of maybe 10, 15 days in between the investigation days. We have many proactive police officers, both in West Bengal police, I come from West Bengal, and also in the Calcutta police and other commissioners. We have seen Saburi Bhattacharya, I remember, Mr. Thambi was the DGCID. I sent him two cases to investigate. She did it miraculously, which I thought I won't get any information about this girl. And sent the answer written back through the DGCID to our office. And I found every details is there. Even when the girl and their parents have changed the address, and now the girl is living in one place, the parents are living in another place. She found all the details. I'm not going into the details of those cases. We are both failures and successes in law enforcement. I don't say all is failure. And when an investigation takes place, 164 statement has been made before the magistrate. And charge sheet has been filed. Judicial action starts. And prosecutors to take up the cases on behalf of the people. In most of the cases, what I find that they are so busy, maybe possibly they have to handle 40, 50, 60, even 100 cases a day. And lesser time for cases of traffic. There, the legal organizations like us, we come in, and the prosecutor is glad to say no objection of the Bhagavatam. Now, prosecution takes place, and we work all over West Bengal with our lawyers in at least at a given time 15 to 20 courts of law. Now what happens when a victim who is lewd, deceived, cheated and forced into prostitution, maybe she has been kidnapped or abducted or threatened or she has been misused to cyber crime, pornographic photos have been sent to her friends and others, and people exploit sexually, even in their residential area and other places. I don't know whether you call it trafficking or not, but this is trafficking. And this is happening quite a lot nowadays. We are handling many cases of those kinds. Now, there are, police is not sure whether someone has talked about the poisonous act. When a child or a woman or a man is coming this side of the border, Bangladesh, Bhutan or Nepal, Nepal is not that difficult because they don't need visa and other things. And now, she either could be arrested as an intruder without documents coming into our country, and one thing very good has happened, that our additional secretary, Ministry of Home Affairs, the then additional secretary, has issued an advisor which says that when you are in doubt, speak especially the child, any woman crossing the border, women and children, interrogate her and see if she is trafficked. You book her in 366B IPC, which allows importation of guard, and also the age is increased because it is 21 years when she is imported, so not limited to 18. So that need to be used by the proactive policies. Still, many of the policies don't use that. They make it very easy, foreigners act without document to be punished under such and such act, and she is brought before the magistrate. Magistrate says, so many years jail will be. And you can find in all the border jails, it is full of Bangladeshi women and girls. In today's state, so much of trafficking has taken place that nearly 3 lakh women and girls are prostituting in places like Karachi and Lahore. 2.5 million women are prostituting, even both Bangladeshi and Indian girls, in Middle East. And they are the victims of trafficking, and it is still continuing. I think the attitudinal change is needed, both for the magistrates, lawyers, prosecutors, and in the police system. Unless that is done, we are not going to get much of the result from it. However, there are some gaps in law. I'm not going into details of that, but you have allotted me 5 to 7 minutes. And I was given this subject of yesterday afternoon. I didn't bring any of that presentation on that as such. But I will say that more than the legal changes or information, we need vigorous implementation of it. We have very good laws. ITP has all the sections I can quote from 1 to the end, but I would say that vigorous implementation is needed. We need good prosecutors to appear before the courts of law. In any court, if you go to find the cases of victims, you will find the best brains of law. At least 5-6 senior lawyers are standing for the accused to face the demand. And it is the lone public prosecutor who serves. In certain courts of law, you will find they are shouting to the magistrates. And they want to get the A on for not for the victim but for the accused. When we take out the victim to send them to A, we have to request the magistrate that we stay in 2 weeks. That please give us forces to put them into train and the guard to go up to certain extent so that they are in safe area. Now what we need is conviction of offenders, and also we need decriminalization of victims. They are not able to get proper rehabilitation and they cannot remain within the community because people show them the fingers, this is the bad girl, she cannot be with us. I would end up with one small case in a minute, is that